Hello students, welcome back. In the previous video, I have covered with the reading of pages 12 and 13 with its detailed analysis. And today I will continue with the reading of pages 14 and 15 with its detailed analysis. By the end of this video, you will be able to know about the advancement in the story. Before starting with the reading, children, I want to mention very important point. Read the text again, so that you can quote important lines and keywords from the story. Keep reading. This video will cover the following objectives. We will try to understand the story, to build critical thinking, to create an overall understanding of and appreciation for literature and individual who produced the masterwork, to build reading skills. Now let us start with the reading on page number 14 of our Echoes textbook. I noticed Jayanto had turned rather quiet after arriving in Bundi. Now underline these lines. Now these lines are creating mysterious and eerie atmosphere, depicting pensive and gloomy mood. So who is sad and whose gloomy mood is being depicted? It is Jayanto. So Jayanto, when they had arrived at Bundi, he had turned quiet. We have read it earlier also. Perhaps some of his memories had returned. So he was able to remember some of his memory related to Bundi, but not all. It is easy enough to feel a little depressed when visiting a place one may have seen as a child. So he says generally, narrator is saying generally that one feels little depressed when one is coming back to the place which he had visited during his childhood. Besides, Jayanto was certainly more emotional than most people. Everyone knew that. But Jayanto was more emotional. So Jayanto was more sensitive. Basically, he wants to say very important point of his character, that Jayanto was more emotional than most people. The narrator has created the mysterious and eerie atmosphere again here by mentioning these lines. He put his cup down on the table and said, "You know, Shankar, it is really quite strange. The first time I came here, I used to sit cross-legged on these chairs. It seemed as though I was sitting on a throne. Now, the chairs seem both small in size and very ordinary. The drawing room here used to seem absolutely enormous." Enormous means huge. "If I hadn't returned, those memories would have remained stuck in my mind forever." So where were they during their visit to Bundi? They were living in the circuit house. Now Jayanto is going back to his flashback mode. He is remembering about the things which he had during his childhood. Now he is remembering about the chairs, how he used to sit when he was a boy who was 6 years old, how was the drawing room. So he is remembering all those things, you know, as he was a child, a 6 years old boy. So he used to sit cross-legged, but now as he had grown up, he won't be able to do that. So he was remembering all this thing. He was feeling very nostalgic at this moment. I said, "Yes, that is perfectly natural. As a child, one is small in size, so everything all else seems large. One grows bigger with age, but the size of all other things remain the same, doesn't it?" So the narrator, Shankar, is taking everything very casual, that it is very natural that other things, they are non-living, they are not going to grow. We as a human, we will be growing, but other things will not. So he says it is natural. He is taking everything very common. But Jayanto, on the other hand, he is feeling more emotional to that place. "We went for a stroll," stroll means walk, "in the garden after tea." Jayanto suddenly stopped walking and said, "Dyodha." I stared at him. Stared means looked continuously. So when they went for a walk in the garden after tea, Jayanto suddenly remembered that there was a deodar tree in the garden when he visited the place in his childhood. A deodar tree. It ought to be here somewhere, he said, and began striding. Striding means walking with long steps towards the far end of the compound. Why did he suddenly think of a deodar tree? Now this line, it is being said by our narrator. So Jayanto felt very excited on the thought of a deodar tree in the garden. But the narrator was a little bit puzzled that why he suddenly thought of a deodar tree. A few seconds later, I heard his voice exclaiming jubilantly, it means happily, "Yes, it is here, exactly where it was before." "Of course, it is where it was before," I said. "Would a tree go roaming about?" So Jayanto was reminded of a deodar tree, which he said ought to be there somewhere in the garden. When he saw it, he was in a happy mood, but the narrator was taking everything very casually. Jayanto shook his head impatiently. "No, that is not what I meant. All I meant was that the tree is where I thought it might be." "But why did you suddenly think of a tree?" Shankar said. So Jayanto was, again I am telling you, he was very excited, and now the memory which had come to him was of a deodar tree. But Shankar was not clear that what was so exciting about that tree. Jayanto stared at the trunk of the tree frowning. Frowning means to contract brows in displeasure. So the author has again created an atmosphere of mystery. Then he shook his head slowly and said, "I can't remember that now. Something had brought me near the tree. I had done something here. A European." "European? No, I can't recall anything at all. Memory is a strange business." So on having a look at deodar tree, Jayanto was trying to recall the memory related to that place. Now he could remember that something European was coming to his mind. So in this line, we can see that how hard Jayanto is trying to remember his past. They had a good cook in the circuit house. Later in the evening, while we sat at the oval dining table having dinner, Jayanto said, "The cook they had in those days was called Dilawar. He had a scar on his left cheek and his eyes were always red. But he was an excellent cook." So after finding that deodar tree, the memories of the place began returning one by one quickly to Jayanto. He remembered that the name of their cook was Dilawar when they were living in the circuit house. He could recall that he was an excellent cook. Jayanto's memories began returning one by one soon after dinner when we went back to the drawing room. He could recall where his father used to sit and smoke a chirut. Chirut is a cigar with a cut square at both sides, where his mother used to knit and what magazines lay on the table. So now he was able to recall the memories that where his father used to smoke and his mother used to knit. And very importantly, what was placed on the table. The things which were placed were magazines. So now we are moving to very important aspect in the story. And slowly, in bits and pieces, he recalled the whole business about his doll. So now we are coming to our doll. So he was able to remember about his unique doll. It was not the usual kind of doll little girls play with. One of Jayanto's uncles had brought for him from Switzerland a 12-inch long figure of an old man dressed in traditional Swiss style. So Jayanto recalled everything about a unique doll his uncle had brought for him from Switzerland. It was 12-inch long figure of an old man. Apparently means describe something that appears to be true. It was very lifelike. Lifelike means looking like a real person or thing. although it was not mechanized, it was possible to bend and twist its limbs. So the doll was very lifelike. It seems to be real. Its face had a smile on it, and on its head it wore a Swiss cap with a little yellow feather sticking out from it. Its clothes, especially in their little details, were perfect. Belt, buttons, pockets, collars, socks. There were even little buckles on the shoes. So in this paragraph, the narrator has done the description of the doll. Moreover, I have also discussed one very important point of style, that is foreshadowing. So he has used foreshadowing the style in this paragraph. So whenever in your exam you will get a question about the description of the doll, so you are going to quote all these lines. His uncle had returned from Europe shortly before Jayanto left for Bundi with his parents. The little old man had been bought in a village in Switzerland. The man who sold him had jokingly said to Jayanto's uncle, "He called Fritz, a doll, inactive but alive. You must call him by this name. He won't respond to any other." The most peculiar thing about the doll was that the man who sold the doll to Jayanto's uncle told him to call it Fritz, as it won't respond to any other name. So students, in this video, I have read pages 14 and 15 with its detailed analysis, in which I have discussed Jayanto and Shankar's stay in the circuit house and memory of Jayanto's best friend, that is Fritz. Your today's homework is to reread pages 14 and 15 for better understanding of the chapter Fritz. Children, again I want to mention my point that reread pages again and again so that you can quote important lines and keywords from the text. Keep reading.